Yeah, welcome back to the forest. My name is Lutz Fehrmann, and in this short tutorial I like to explain you how to measure the height of a tree with a Blumeleis or Zunto hypsometer. For both of these devices we can find similar alternatives with the Haga instrument and the Silver Clinomaster, but I will use these ones for my explanations. All of these instruments that I show in this tutorial can only measure inclination angles, so they are not able to measure distances. You remember that for the trigonometric principle we need a distance and we need angles. With these devices we need to find a fixed horizontal distance to the tree to make use of these angle scales here in the instrument. If we are in one of these horizontal distances that we can choose, which is 15, 20, 30 or 40 meter, we can take an angle reading and we can directly read the height of the tree on the corresponding scale. So we don't need to calculate. What we read on the scale is the distance times tangent of the inclination angle. You see that I marked the tree there in the background and that I laid out a tape to measure the distance. I'm more or less on a flat terrain here. But this Blumeleis hypsometer also gives me another opportunity to find the fixed distance that I need to measure the tree. Therefore, we find a small hole here on the side of the instrument. If we look through this, we look through a prism. And on the tree, I have fixed a vertical base, which is, in principle, a black long thing with white stripes. And if I look through this prism, I will see two pictures, the original picture and the mirrored picture. And by moving forward and backward, I can adjust my distance to the tree such that the white stripes in these two pictures are exactly on the same level. And we can have a look on how this works if we go closer to the tree. So, the vertical base that I fixed here on this tree and that I will see through my prism is a black scale with white stripes, and these white stripes are for different distances, 15, 30, and on the other side we also have other distances. If you look through this small prism, the picture is split into two parts that are moving against each other if you go away or closer to the tree. So by moving forward and backward, you try to find the position where these white stripes are exactly on the same level. And this works quite well. So if you control this with your tape, you will find out that this is a quite precise measurement of a fixed distance to the tree. So once you find a position in the correct distance, where you can see the tree top and the base of the stem, you are now going to take two measurements of angles. For this purpose, you need to press the button to release the pendulum inside the Blumeleis here, and you aim through the device pointing to the top of the tree. If you release the button, this pendulum is fixed, and in this case, in this Blumeleis number 6 model, I can take a second measurement with a second pendulum to the base of the stem. And I fix the pendulum, and now I can make a reading on the correct scale. The tree that I was measuring now has a height of more than 20 meters, so I'm here in a distance of 30 meters, which is more than one tree length. If I now make a reading of the first height, I get 28 here, and for the second height to the base of the stem, I get minus 1 meter. You remember from my introduction, we are always calculating height 1 minus height 2. In this case, height 2 is a negative height. So we have 28 minus minus 1, which is 29 meters, which is more or less exactly also the distance that I use to measure this tree. So is that now the correct tree height that we have measured now? Well, in this case, yes, because we are working in a quite flat terrain. As soon as you are working in a sloped area and you find your position only on a slope, and you measure a slope distance to the tree, then we need to correct this tree height, because the scales in this instrument expect that we are in the correct horizontal distance. If we measure a slope distance, then we are at the end a little bit closer to the tree than expected by the scales. For this purpose, we would measure a slope angle by aiming upwards or downwards the slope in the direction to the tree, aiming in the height of my eyes, for example, on another tree, and then I can read an angle here in degrees from the device, and I can use a correction factor on the backside of the instrument to reduce the tree height. For example, if I have a slope angle of 15 or 16 degrees, it would mean that the cosine of this angle is the correction factor, which is around 0.96, so we would need to subtract 4% of this measured tree height in slope terrain. Okay, everything that I have explained for this Blumelis clinometer now would more or less equally also hold for this Zunto clinometer, which is a slightly smaller device. Don't mix it up with the Zunto compass, which looks very similar because it has the same body, but this tool is also measuring vertical angles. The only difference in this case is that I cannot look through the instrument. I have a small window here, but here I only see the scales for different distances, so I need to keep both eyes open, aim at the top and aim at the base to read the tree height. The distances for the two scales we have in this instrument here, in this model, they refer to 15 and 20 meter distance or a multiple of that, and you find this information always at the end of the scale, so if you look down, then you see for which distance you should use which scale. So this is a quite handy tool and a very robust tool. At the end, I'd like to show you one additional tool provided by Haglöf. This one is an electronic tool, but this one is also measuring angles. So we are measuring vertical angles here exactly like with the other devices. The only difference with this tool is that we can set any fixed distance. So we are a little bit more flexible with the distance to the tree because we can adjust it. Also here you cannot look through the device, you need to set your distance and then you are measuring an angle to the top of the tree and an angle to the base of the tree, and the device directly calculates the corresponding tree height. Also this one is very handy and a very nice pocket tool, and there are different models of this one. Some of them can even measure horizontal angles or also distances to the tree. Okay, enough for these three devices. In the next video, I will come to some other very typical standard devices that we use in forest inventories, but these are also able to measure distances, what makes them especially interesting because we are much more flexible in finding a good position where we can see the whole tree. So, see you in one of our next tutorials. Bye-bye.